I decided to concentrate on nuclear matter, which means the limit of what nuclei would look like if there were no electric force inside the nucleus, if you had only the nuclear forces. In that case, you could have infinitely big nuclei, and that would make the theory very much simpler. I had a nice starting point, a theory by Brueckner, which concerned just nuclear matter. And the trick of that theory was that inside the nucleus, each nucleon had its own energy. And the energy of individual nucleons could be calculated in a consistent manner, consistent with the calculation of the nucleus as a whole. I went into this theory and first simplified it greatly. And then, together with Goldstone, one of my graduate students in Cambridge, was able to solve one problem in that theory, namely what happens when there is a very strong repulsion between two nucleons at very short distance. And such repulsion was in fact observed experimentally in Berkeley when they investigated the scattering of protons by protons at hundreds of millions of electron volts. And what Goldstone and I did was to investigate what such a strong repulsion would do to the wave function of a couple of nucleons interacting with each other. And this was very satisfactory and gave the basis of treating nuclear matter in general. Goldstone then went on to make a very fundamental contribution to the theory of elementary particles, finding that in a field theory you could create an extra particle which you don't put into the theory, and it is now believed that the pi meson is of this type. I had another very superior graduate student in Cambridge, both of them assigned to me by Nevill Mott, who was then the chairman of the physics department at Cambridge. The name of the second one was Thouless. He did a thesis with me after I returned to Cornell, and in that thesis essentially gave a much more fundamental description of the way the Brueckner theory works and the way you treat nuclear matter. Thouless went on to become one of the leading theorists in condensed matter theory. I believe he is about as profound in this area as any other theorist.